Hi and welcome to my sixth video in the series about microorganisms and health, and today we're going to be looking at antigenetic variation. So many of the problems, particularly with viruses, is the fact that they can mutate and change. So if we looked at a typical virus, so for instance this might represent a flu virus, and on the surface of this flu virus you have the antigens represented by these yellow triangles. Now, if you got infected with the flu, what you'd expect is a normal immune response, and so for you to produce the relevant antibody. And if you remember back to previous videos, then these antibodies need to have a specific shape that's complementary to the antigen shape, a bit like this one. And so what then can end up happening is the antibody can bind to the antigen and begin to clump loads of these viruses together. Now at this point what's happened is you've then built up memory cells within your system, so that if you're exposed to this pathogen again, you'll have a very, very quick secondary response and a very, very large one, and hence you won't get ill again. But the problem comes specifically with things like flu is in the fact that they mutate very, very readily. And by mutate, what I mean is there's a genetic change. Now this mutation can happen when it's making a copy of itself, and because some viruses can do this quite sloppily, then they won't make an exact copy and they'll make mistakes within the DNA. And so the issue here is that if there is a mutation and this mutation happens to change the actual shape of the antigen, then that can be a huge benefit for the microorganism. However, I should stress that most mutations are not a benefit to the actual virus or to the microorganism. Most will actually result in it failing and therefore not promoting survival. But essentially, if there is one mutation that is beneficial, then it's likely to pass on. And so in this instance, and in the case of this mutation, this one's a clear benefit. The antigen has changed shape, and now our antibody no longer is able to fix to it. And so therefore we need to go through the entire process where we need to locate the specific B cell that actually produces the specific antibody. Now that may take some period of time in order to do that. You may eventually find it. But if this disease is one which is very, very dangerous, and if that latent period is much too long, then that can cause serious issues down the line. So in the case of the flu virus can cause damage to your cells, and if it causes damage to enough cells or to enough sensitive cells, it can actually result in serious illness, and specifically in older people or younger people can result actually in death. And this is part of the flu's survival mechanism. The fact that it's able to survive for long periods of time is down to the fact that it mutates readily and changes, and therefore our immune system has to catch up constantly, and it's a constant arms race between our white blood cells and invading microorganisms like flu. Another one of the survival mechanisms for the flu virus is the fact that it can combine with other strains of flu and produce new novel strains. So in the case of these two, I mean it's quite simplistic here with the two different shapes, but they're able to combine to produce new antigens and a different strain of the flu virus, and hence we've had outbreaks of avian and swine flu in this country. The fact that the flu mutates so readily is the reason why we need a new vaccination every year. We end up having to fight a different strain of flu from year to year, so by using a previous year's vaccination it would be completely ineffective against the current flu virus. Okay, so in summary, when a pathogen reproduces it can mutate, and so this is true for all of the different types of pathogen, be it fungi, bacteria or viruses. This mutation, most will be a non-benefit, but the ones that are a benefit could potentially lead to a change in antigen shape, and this means that the memory cells that you've built up in resistance to these specific pathogens are no longer useful. Also, viruses can not only mutate in that fashion, but they can also combine with different strains of viruses and therefore produce a new strain of which the antibodies that you've produced are useless.